You know the problem. Why is it you buy a new laptop, you get 4 hours of runtime, 2 months later you get 2 hours, and 6 months later it's barely 1 hour? How can that be? The cry of consumers and people everywhere in going into the electrification, there's a huge need for battery. I have 20 years experience in this field, and I'm here to provide one puzzle piece in the future of electrification, which entails the car, utility, and the true mobility, a battery that you can trust. We started a company after 15 years of success in the lithium-ion field, pioneered by the Japanese and Koreans, coming from the US innovation power around Boston, now deployed with a platform of sustainability. Our battery in the laptop lasts for 3 years, 4 hours every day for 3 years, charging in 30 minutes, mobility, instead of 3 hours typically, enabling the electric car to be real. Green, the first to be accredited, enabling green transportation. Actually, it's remarkable and fun and exhilarating to be putting our batteries into the gas tank of a car to fuel some of the motorbikes coming into Beijing of China and to think about the cold climate. We can operate down at minus 20, minus 30 degrees C. Ultimately, the enabling partner to our gentleman here, the battery, the energy storage, making wind a system, sun able to come in small systems or large systems, to actually leverage geothermal and hydropower to even out the grid and make instant profits. We're powering new missions. Go to the moon. You need a battery that actually works. Complicated, complex systems where we can use consumer-based electronic solution for sense and operating with a new platform of batteries. New chemistry, new mechanical solutions, and new manufacturing techniques to get very high yields and cost competitive. And yet, this is a Lego piece. Three for a laptop, 2,000 for 250 kilometers of drive in an electric car, all electric, or maybe 20,000 for a utility storage plant. Any shape you like. Company has paid a lot of attention to IP. Many of us came from the innovation space. 122 patents in various stages of filing, including the chemistry, the mechanical engineering, the electronics, and ornamental patents and design elements. We are able to do the handshake between the power and the application. We started a global company. We started in Boston with a beautiful arena of intellectuals and took it immediately to the pragmatic China to deploy prototypes that worked. We now have mass production in Taiwan and growing a very large plant in Chongqing, China. We're here as a global company at the onset of electrification. Perhaps as part of the solution to what Copenhagen wanted to accommodate, the business community will need to do. Clean tech has arrived, and it's up to us in this room and in this world to deploy it. Technology is here. R&D has delivered. A life of opportunity. An era of unmatched business prospects and growth. We dream about green jobs. I think we can say it's here. An opportunity for new partnerships, for new leaderships, and for green technologies to actually enable huge markets. A few numbers. Portable electronics shipped 140 million laptops last year. That market, just the battery, has a worth in today's market between 5 and 10 billion, growing to 50 to 70 billion. The little people, us, no longer the large powers of politics. We need to do this. We need to embrace the electrification of transportation as a business opportunity. This is a $250 billion market where the power alone is worth probably a third of that. I see a future with great hope. Laptop providers don't have to complain anymore. You can stop about worrying and actually deploying technology. You will have solar options with energy storage locally, and you will be able to enjoy electrification in transportation. Ultimately, maybe the biggest question we're wrestling, energy securities, which ultimately leads to justice, and I think, peace. Thank you.